Hello and welcome everyone to Hero's Journey, the thing we do to explain movies.
Today's topic, Shrek 3. Are you ready? Too bad, because we're starting.
Part 1, Ordinary World. In this part, Shrek is in far, far away, hanging out with his wife Fiona, doing all sorts of stuff. It's pretty neat, to be honest. Now you got the call to adventure. See, this is where Shrek, obviously, is next on line to the throne, because the king has died, and he needs someone new. So they want to make Shrek king, is what they're trying to do. Oh yeah, also, Fiona wants to have kids with Shrek, and that's something else. Then you got the refusal to the call. Shrek doesn't want kids, and he doesn't want to be king, because he thinks he's not fit for it. He broke a boat over there, I don't know. So, what the king tells him is that there's someone else out there that is fit for the throne. And that's step 4, meeting the mentor. Now, the mentor is Arthur, the new person that's gonna replace the throne. So, we have crossing the threshold, which is separating ordinary world from the special world. Now, this is the high school, obviously, because Shrek's not used to high school, he can't really relate. Then there's test, allies, and enemies. Well, when they're on their way home, Shrek is telling Arthur about these cool things of being a king, but then his friends are telling Arthur, nah, being a king is kinda hard and stuff. And so Arthur tries to go back when Shrek's like, nah, fam, you gotta go this way. So they end up crashing. They end up at the crazy dude's house. That's the retired magic teacher. The innermost cave is the part where Shrek and Arthur kinda sit down and talk about each other. Arthur lost his dad. Well, his dad left him. Obviously, that was one of the things. Then Shrek was talking about how his dad wasn't very nice. He tried to eat him, so that's kind of not cool. So that's pretty neat. So they kind of have this connection. That's kind of the part that they get the connection. Here we have the ordeal, death and rebirth. And in this part, Shrek and Arthur have to face off with some Prince Charming's henchmen. Oh yeah, by the way, if you weren't paying attention, you didn't have to because I forgot to mention that Prince Charming took over Far Far Away Land with some of his henchmen, but we aren't going to get up to that now. There's the reward of seizing the Force, which is that they defeat them together because of how talented they are. They finally make it back to Far Far Away Land. The donkey and Puss in Boots switch, I don't know. The old guy helped, that was cool. And then there's the resurrection when Shrek is saved by Arthur as he's about to be killed by Hans and all of his like soldiers and stuff. That was kind of the big part of the story. And then, of course, there's the return with the elixir, which is Shrek returns with his swamp and decides to have kids with Fiona because he's a good husband. Yeah, I don't know what I'm doing here anymore.